You don't get to choose if you get hurt in this world, but you do have a say in who hurts you.
I am in love with you, Hazel Grace.
And I know that love is just a shout into the void and that oblivion is inevitable.
And I am in love with you.
All your efforts to keep me from you are gonna fail.
We are a hot mess.
Are you angry?
So angry.
You need to break something.
You gave me a forever with him, the number of days, and I can't tell you how thankful I am for our little infinity.
It's a good life, Hazel Grace.
Okay.
Okay.
Hi, everyone. Well, at the orders of my executive producer, I saw a non-action film this time, and the film I chose was The Fault in Our Stars, adapted from the book written by John Green. That's right, we've made another stop in the book adaptation universe. And as you all may recall, the only stop that's been worth it was my trip to see Catching Fire, which I gave an 8.8 out of 10 to. The Mortal Instruments City of Bones, Vampire Academy, and Divergent scored a 5, a 5.5, and a 6.5 respectively. What went wrong with those adaptations? Was it because the story was poorly translated to screen? Was the casting off? Am I just a picky critic? Who cares about that? Let's get down to business. Welcome to Short and to the Point, where I review movies in 5 minutes or less, or your money back.
I've been in search of storms, making up the pavement of less traveled roads, mining for treasure deep in my boat that I never found.
Our story follows teenager Hazel Grace, who has to carry a portable oxygen tank on her at all times because her thyroid cancer has affected her lungs. But does she let that get her down? Not exactly. She pretty much acts like any other person you could run into on the street, while she isn't in denial about her cancer, and Shailene Woodley does a good job bringing this character to life. At the request of her mother, played by Laura Dern, Hazel goes to a cancer support group where she meets Augustus Waters, played by Ansel Elgort, whom you might remember as being Caleb Pryor in Divergent, which also starred Shailene Woodley. The minute these two conversed, the film started to win me over. Well, actually, it started to win me over when I heard Shailene's delivery of Hazel's snarky dialogue, but since this is a love story, how well the two lead characters fit together is the most important part of the movie. Our protagonists have an awkward first meeting when Hazel is offered a cigarette by Augustus, which leads to a humorous discussion between them about the metaphorical meaning of carrying around cigarettes despite not lighting them. Like I said, I am liking these two already, and it isn't just because of the writing. It's legitimate chemistry between our two leads. They play off of one another excellently, and the description really can't do it justice. Even the conversations they have through text messages are humorously adorable. Whenever the messages appear on screen, I can actually hear the characters' voices in my head as I read them. That's how well Shailene and Ansel embody Hazel and Augustus. The movie is also paced well enough that when the inevitable I love yous are exchanged, it doesn't feel like we've waited a lifetime for them to be said, even though the film does take its time to get these two characters officially paired up. Hazel and Augustus' relationship isn't all sugar, spice, and everything nice, however. Like something out of a Joss Whedon show, when these two characters are on top of the world, something happens that brings them crashing back down, and the movie is pretty good about choosing the moments when things go wrong for our lovebirds. It's also pretty good at bringing the audience along for the ride on this emotional roller coaster, as we have every reason to be on top of the world with them before suddenly being reminded that at any minute, this happy couple could cease to be. We already know that Hazel has problems, but as it turns out, Augustus has issues of his own that push him past simply being the supportive boyfriend character. Yeah, it sucks, but as Hazel's favorite book states, pain demands to be felt, and boy does it let us have it. I've already talked about how much I like the two lead characters' performances, but the supporting cast does a good job also. For example, the look of utter devastation that appears on Hazel's mother's face when she tells her daughter that she can let go before bursting into tears was so convincing that it was like a punch to the gut. Okay, it wasn't that dramatic, but it was still pretty heavy. Another highlight for the supporting cast was Nat Wolff, who plays Isaac. He primarily serves as the third wheel to Augustus and Hazel, and despite the fact that he went blind due to a tumor, he is actually one of the funniest characters in the movie. Ironically enough, a lot of his humor actually occurs simultaneously with his drama, but the drama is still there, even if it's not quite as pronounced as the comedy. Again, pain demands to be felt, but people just have different ways of dealing with it. Now, if I have to nitpick a criticism for this film, I guess it will be Peter Van Houten, who is played by William Dafoe. His acting is okay, but something about his character kind of bugged me. He's rather hard to figure out, and I guess that's the point. But his tendency to not give straight answers was kind of annoying, mainly because the scenes he was in ended before I had a chance to figure out what he meant, and these scenes don't last very long, despite the fact that he plays a semi-significant role in the story. Overall, I enjoyed The Fault in Our Stars, so what made it different from the other adaptations I saw? Was it because the studio just picked a good book to adapt? Well, no, as the other movies I reviewed were all adapted from positively received books. It just comes down to how the story was represented on screen. I never read The Fault in Our Stars, but never once during this movie did I think, "Yeah, the story is alright, but it was probably better represented in book form." This movie just cast its actors well, it knew when to make us laugh, and it knew when to make us cry. Well, I didn't cry, maybe a little teary-eyed. Never mind. I give it 8.5 lovesick teenagers out of a possible 10, and I do recommend it for a theatrical viewing. This has been Short and to the Point, and I review movies in 5 minutes or less, your money back. You know, with Transformers 4 looming over the horizon, you would think that we were close to the end of the summer season, but no, we're barely in the thick of it. I still have movies to review in the future such as Guardians of the Galaxy and the James Brown film Get On Up, which both come out on August 1st. Just a friendly heads up, I will be reviewing Get On Up first, so I probably should brush up on my dancing skills then. I will see you all next time. Bye.